Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to discuss the three reasons why you should not buy a home. I'm not exactly advising you not to buy a house at all, but before you buy a house, just make sure that you have these three important things in place, especially with our very unpredictable economy with what's going on. I hope that you will learn something from my advice based on my experience selling real estate for over a decade now. The first reason is that you should not buy a house if you don't have enough savings in your bank account for at least 6 to 9 months worth of savings. 3 months is usually what majority of financial advisors will tell you, but however, in my opinion, it is better to be more conservative and go 6 to 9 months. Reason is that you need at least 3 months to allocate for emergency and at least 6 months of savings that you could take out anytime when you need to. And this will actually make you feel good and less stressed and makes you more calm in going about your days if you know that you have enough in your bank account or maybe keep it under your mattress. Yeah, so you hear different stories nowadays with banks and everything else out there. It is a very good idea to have at least 6 to 9 months of liquid in your possession or in your savings account, wherever you feel comfortable in keeping them. Also, that you will need money set aside in case the house that you have bought needed some repairs, because this plumbing and all these issues can get very expensive and you could end up paying thousands of dollars. Although you have all the physical inspections prior to buying the house, it is still very important to set aside savings for that repairs. And especially if you are going to rent this house out, you cannot really control what the tenants will do with the house. This is another topic that I could discuss on another video if you are thinking of investing in real estate. And depending on the type of property that you are planning to purchase, you need to make sure you have an allocated amount that is reasonable for it. That way you don't end up borrowing money from the banks and paying extra interest. If you don't have it, it could really bring you down to the ground, and it can be very expensive. Then interest could just add up over time. The next reason why you shouldn't buy a house is if you don't have enough down payment. 20% or more, or at least 20%, is the recommended down payment. That way you will prevent paying higher interest. At the same time, mortgage insurance, which is actually just really helping the bank in case you can't pay for your mortgage, they are more likely will be protected, but not you. So it's like paying for a car insurance for someone else, which has really nothing to do with you. So it is better to at least have 20% of down payment, because the bank will charge you mortgage insurance, because if you have less down payment, you have a very low skin in the game, and if something bad happens, you can easily just walk out. And so the bank know this stuff. Of course, they are in business to make money. In every transaction, you have to have an exit strategy just so you can protect yourself and your finances. And the third reason why you shouldn't buy a house is if your mortgage payment is more than 25% of your net take-home pay. Some people, they would calculate it from their gross pay, but actually you have to calculate it from your net take-home pay. So 25% would be acceptable, and at least you can still breathe and have a life. You don't want to live your life where you're a slave to your house and you just find yourself working 2 jobs, 3 jobs, and not even being able to enjoy your home and never home because you have to pay your mortgage. So that's, I just don't really agree with that scenario. And you have less freedom to live your life and breathe. Some people, I see that their health is getting affected because of having such a big house, and they are becoming so unhappy. And that's not where you want to be. It is very sad. It is an American dream, but it's really like a hamster around and around and nowhere to go. And you find yourself just working so much. That seems normal in America to have a big house for most people, but it is really not an ideal way to live your life. And plus, if you are in a lot of stress and you're overworked, you don't have a balance, you most likely going to risk your health. So It's a matter of what's your priority, your health, money, or a big house. So you have to really think about this before buying, because real estate is such a big investment and you don't want it to be a liability. In some cases, it is even better to just rent depending on the area that you are going to live. And yes, renting is not a bad idea because it actually is less stressful and you can move easily and you're not feeling tied up. I know I shouldn't say this because I sell real estate and I would love for you to buy a home with me, but I just being realistic and I want to make sure I will guide you in the right path. And a couple things I'd like to add for an advice on this video, especially if you have children or dependents, it is very important to at least have a pension plan in place or retirement in place. Also, life insurance with cash value is also a good investment to prepare just in case you were to pass away. And if you have a big house and you don't have a lot of money, I mean, how can your kids pay for that house? So they will end up losing the house. But if you have life insurance in place, that will really protect them in case something happened to you. This was actually even mentioned in The Richest Man of Babylon. In that book, I have been giving that as a gift to my clients back in the days when I was new selling real estate. And that book will give you a lot of wisdom on finances, retirement and investment in place, getting it from your job or investing on your own is a good idea as well, because not all of us are loaded with cash or money. And so that we can start some kind of investment for a small amount of money. And there are a lot of products out there. You just research and you can even watch YouTube videos on what people are investing in and learn from it and find which one that makes sense to you. Because of course, it's not like all of us can just go ahead and buy 10 properties and get cash flows from that. There's only very few people that are blessed to be able to do that. And so you have to have some kind of investment that possibly could give you a return and not put all your money on a house. All right, so I hope that you learned something on this video. And don't forget to check out my Instagram page. I have all the houses that we currently have for a listing in our office posted in there. And if you have questions, you can directly message me on my Instagram at Zona Luxury Homes. You take care and have a good day. Thank you so much again for watching me. And I cannot wait to see you on the next one.